first thing, just trying to compose this or position this sketch dot just a little bit, and still think of this as a two-point perspective where you're trying to find the length, the width, and the height, a little bit more of a mechanical piece. And if I can start this off in a box shape, it makes it that much easier to see it. So I'm just going to elevate this a little bit. So even though this seat is slanted, I'm just going to start out relatively square, just so I can get some of the proportions set up on this side. Kind of there. So then trying to estimate the height of everything that goes in there. So again, keeping the lines parallel is going to be key in helping you establish this segment. So just estimating the sketch, just freehanding it in at first. Checking that out. And you can always check the proportion of the seat. If you were designing this off from your own, then it would take on a whole different level there for you. Dropping this down a little side panel. And try to look at the shapes, a little tapering here. Build this up. Again, since this was drawn out straight, just slanting it a little bit. Just a little more look to it. And still just keeping it loose, roughing this out. So trying to draw through the object, you can see that all these lines going, say, if it was to the right vanishing point, are at least parallel in this sketch, on the left parallel, and then you have any vertical lines that may come up above that. And then once you have it, checking out the proportion, you can easily just render this out. Holder here. Now I can, if I want to, just use a straight edge to help me really define these lines. These are parallel, it's easy to place this in here. So again, just showing you at least the initial beginning of it. Sets that in there very easily. there. So you can see it's pretty quickly sketched out. So again, you have two different textures, two different colors. Try to see if you can simulate that look to it. It does have a cast shadow, but it's not perfectly light, the whitest color in here. And even in this circular part, use a template. gives you the beginning selection, and there's just a lot of tone fitting afterwards. Let's see if we can blend in some of that. Just using a little crosshatch just to help with the texture of this fabric. That'll give me a little. Cast shadow here on the object itself.